again, this is Wes Lee, and we're back for another segment talking about winds in Oklahoma. There's definitely some variability in the wind patterns of Oklahoma throughout the year. We tend to have our heaviest or highest wind speeds in the late spring, so that would be April and May. It is not uncommon for 10 to 15 mile an hour winds on average daily during that time of year. This year in 2022, it was an exceptionally windy spring. April came in as the windiest month on average that we have ever recorded with Oklahoma Mesonet in nearly 30 years. May also came in well above normal for average wind speeds. When we get into the summer months of later June, July, and August, the winds tend to calm down and we have some of those dog days of summer where it is extremely hot. To measure the wind on our Mesonet towers, we use two different devices called an anemometer. This is the larger one that sets at the top of our towers at 10 meter, or about 33 feet. So anytime you see winds on the news, you can rest assured that it came from the standard height of 33 feet tall when they report it. Winds are important for a couple of different variables. One is when we are spraying pesticides, especially herbicides, we want to avoid days when those windy conditions would carry that product off-site. So on the Oklahoma Mesonet, we have a tool called the Drift Risk Advisor that uses a forecast that will estimate when are the best hours to spray over the next 3.5 days. And you can use this as a planning tool when you're putting out those herbicides to try to avoid drift on your neighbor's property or some sensitive plants like tomatoes out there. Now, in the summertime, we would actually like to have a little better winds than we normally get in June, July, and August, because that tends to keep us cooler as we evaporate the sweat that develops on our skin. But as I mentioned earlier, it tends to be one of the slowest wind speed times of the year. High wind speeds do contribute to something called evapotranspiration. The higher the wind speeds, the more moisture is lost from the plants and from the soil surface. So when we have those windier times, windier months, we have to be more concerned about the water that's being lost from plants and from ground, tilled ground, and replace that water with irrigation. In the summer months, since the winds tend to be a little bit lower, it's more of a heat factor that determines how much irrigation we need to apply to the plants. Our anemometers tell us multiple things. They tell us the wind speed. We send that data out to subscribers on an app or on the website every 5 minutes. But we actually take a reading every 2 to 3 seconds on the tower. That fastest 2 to 3 second reading will be the wind gust. The average of all of those readings over a 5 minute period will be the wind speed. And then, of course, the devices like this are also able to determine wind direction, and we report that either as degrees or in north, south, east, or west directional arrows. So a recap on wind speeds: the windiest time of the year on average is those spring months, April and May. The slowest wind speeds tends to be the summer months of July, August, maybe September. Then the winds tend to pick up again in the fall and over into winter. And that's when they start contributing towards something called wind chill on our temperature maps. Be sure to access Oklahoma Mesonet information either on an app for smartphones or on our website at mesonet.org.
We hope you enjoyed this video as part of our Oklahoma Gardening YouTube channel. You can also find even more videos on the OK Gardening Classics YouTube channel. And join us on social media for great gardening tips, photos, and discussion.